soul saves it. Save it. Save it. The love of many will grow cold. That is love towards God. Why? Because of the increase of evils. So the more the evils are increasing, the more the love of many grows cold. One, if your love towards God grows cold, your love towards your spouse will grow cold. That is an automatic thing. If you leave the presence of God, then you will not be able to maintain your love between your between a husband and wife. A husband who leaves the presence of God cannot love the wife the way he's supposed to love this wife. Why? God is our standard measure. God is our standard measure when it comes to marriage. So if the love is not growing, you cannot show the other person mercy. That truth will also be already at another stage whereby if truth lacks in between a couple, if that truth lacks in between a couple, you are not truthful. Whatever you're saying, you are not fulfilling. Whatever you are promising, you are not doing it. Whatever you want to do because you are not merciful, a person who is not merciful is a wicked person. And there are husbands and some wives who have turned to be something else because that love is no longer there. So if you cannot constantly love God, you cannot love your spouse. Understand, where there is love, there is jealousy.
Mm-hmm.
And God cannot allow you. You get lost into loving your wife or loving your husband and you have abandoned him. He will react. And the moment he reacts, your love will be distorted somehow. So the word says, in verse 3, let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart.
Yeah.
So people who are in love, they are people who are merciful. They are people that we can say they are kind to one another. But you can meet a husband and a wife who are unkind. They don't even have that any connection to show that they are connected, they are married, they are flowing together, and they are moving in the same direction. And also another scripture is
before you go to another scripture.
Yes, yes.
There's
yes.
Something very sensitive.
Yeah, yeah.
That you have already said.
Mm-hmm.
The husband who is very unkind,
yeah,
and this husband is very unkind or is wicked. What is the cause of this?
Because
we talked this in the foundation.
Yeah,
that's what I want to remind our viewers,
mm-hmm.
because they forgot. Most of them might have forgotten what we really discussed.
Yeah,
when we were talking about love, submission,
mm-hmm.
we say. When marriage is without agape love,
yeah,
without agape love,
mm.
marriage is full of chaos.
Yeah.
When a marriage is minus agape love, it is full of chaos.
Mm-hmm.
It's chaotic
mm.
and selfish and always full of quarrels.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So people are always quarreling because agape love is dead. Marriage without filial love, which is brotherly love,
yeah, that's okay.
the husband becomes wicked. So that's the reason why people are now experiencing that mm-hmm. kind of wickedness,
mm-hmm.
that a man can have the whole salary and then run away and the children are suffering.
Yeah.
The last dress that you bought for your wife is the one that she bought during the day of the wedding.
Actually, that's the
from that time, there is no more dress
that's
you have ever bought for your wife. And women talk until sometimes we feel pain.
Mm. Mm.
I don't remember the last time my husband bought me anything.
Yeah, yeah.
The dress that I have is what we bought during the wedding. From there, he does not take care of me at all.
Actually, I manage the little that I get.
Then I buy something.
Then I buy something.
So my husband does not care at all. We have such men. We have such women. We want to hear you speak. This is your forum. You speak. And some of you, you need to check at each other. When is the last time you bought something for your spouse? When is the last time you bought a dress for your wife? What is the last time you bought a gift? You brought something to your wife or to your husband? Can you remember? If it's forget, you are forgetting, it means failure love is dead. Brotherly love is not in that marriage. Then we said again, marriage without eros love is usually strenuous. Yeah. It strains the relationship. And couples always are in disagreement, which leads also to adultery.
Yeah.
That's lack of eros love or romantic love. And then marriage without eros, you see now it's open doors for adultery. Marriage without eros or eros love is usually short-lived. It is a short-lived happiness. It's surely, if the marriage is only built on that, it will have short-lived happiness. Because eros love is not a giving love, it's a demanding love. That is the funny thing about the eros love. It's a demanding love. It's not a giving love. So the reason why now we are seeing this level where people do not have the concern about the other person. You hear that the last time the husband bought something for the wife can't remember for those years of marriage. The last time the wife cooked for some for their husband, sometimes it's not known for some. Their men were doing laundry for themselves, doing everything for themselves, not because they like it. It's because the woman said, I can't.
They resist.
He resisted. And this man says, furthermore, I was still doing these things even before I got married to this woman. So in other words, this woman has no place. She has not entered her place. There are some things that are happening in the marriage because they have allowed what the Proverbs has told us. You can go back there again so that somebody will get this understanding of Proverbs 3. Verse 3, which is a very key thing that every couple must understand this, and I believe God is going to help us and help us to move on well in life.
Right. It says, "Let not mercy and truth
forsake thee." Let not mercy and truth forsake thee.
Bind them around your
Bind them around your neck.
Write them on the tablet of your heart.
Write them on tablet of the heart. What is the benefit? Verse 4 tells us the benefit.
And so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man.
Now look at that. If you allow love and faithfulness and mercy move away from you, you lack favor. Favor before God and favor before man. And even your wife is a man. Your husband is a man. So there are couples that are not enjoying favor before each other, simply because they allowed love and mercy. They allowed it to go. Love and
mercy.
It's no longer with them. And that is why favor has now gone. You understand? You don't understand why you don't appeal to your spouse anymore. There is a problem. You want to reach out to this person, but the way he looks at you is not the way he used to look at you before.
You are no longer favorite.
Because you allowed something very important to live your life.
You forsake
love mercy, and mercy.
Mercy and truth.
And truth. Those are things that you are supposed to hold on and hang on to your neck and continue doing this, having mercy, having truth, and also being in love. This is going to help you to get favor before God and before man. So we say this, each couple vowed to take care of each other. It is not a man who is supposed to take care of the woman and the woman not take care of the man. Each one of us has a responsibility. I have a responsibility to take care of my wife and my wife has responsibility to take care of me. Now, there are some spouses who have been left out completely by others. They are not in the plan. Maybe you are a pastor, maybe. You are taking care of the other flock. You don't take care of your wife. You are owned. You have ignored.
Actually, that one is
that becomes also a challenge. You are taking care of others, but you don't take care of your own. You forsake. And the Bible says, a man who does not take care of his own house, immediately those, the members were immediate members. He has disowned what? Faith.
Mm-hmm.
So this person has disowned faith because you can't take care of what is yours. So taking care of your family and being good in your family also qualifies you to be a leader in the house of God. Because the Bible says, if you can't take care of your own family, how can you take care of the affairs of the house of God? So it's a responsibility of each one of us to take care of each other.
Mm-hmm.
You are your wife's keeper, and you are your husband's keeper. You need to get concerned about their welfare. You need to care about them, how they feel, how they are faring on. There's some couples, even they wake up, they don't talk to each other. They don't ask each other even how was the night. Say, we slept together. Sleeping you together does not make sure that you are aware of the other person.
Actually, the lady told me at last, and I think this week, he told me these teachings has helped us so much. So she was telling me, can you imagine? Me, I was just waking up, because I remember sometimes back I told them, it's like an abomination. You wake up, you leave your husband, even if he's asleep, wake him up. Tell this man you're leaving.
Yeah.
So she was telling me, I've just started to do that, and my husband
is
wondering, and he's telling me, go and may the Lord be with you, go and let it be well with you.
Mm-hmm.
And this man, it's not that he's not born again,
yeah,
but he's telling the wife, he's blessing
the wife to go.
So the wife was wondering, so there's something that I have not been doing in my marriage for all these years. She was telling me, I was just waking up, I go. Then we'll meet in the evening, or maybe 2 days after. So you can imagine in such a scenario. You just go, the other one goes, as you're saying, you just wake up, no one is talking to the other, you prepare, you leave, the other one prepares, leave.
And you don't care about the other. Now look at this. The little love is explained in the book of 1 Corinthians. I think that's where you are going to.
Yes, yes.
1 Corinthians 13. And verse 4 to 8, so that somebody will understand, so that when you say you love, and this is not just love, the ordinary love, it's the agape love.
Yeah.
It's well all described in this book of 1 Corinthians chapter is 13, and the whole book of Corinthians chapter 13 explains love.
Yeah.
What is the importance of this love? But let us read for you in verse 4. Verse 8 is telling us what is love really.
This is what the word of the Lord says. Love suffers long and
love
is kind.
Love is long suffering.
And is kind.
Love is kind.
Love does not envy.
Love does not envy.
Love does not parade itself.
Love does not parade itself or boast.
It's not puffed up.
Uh-huh.
Does not behave rudely.
Uh-huh.
Does not seek its own.
Uh-huh.
Is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails, but whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part. But then I shall know just as I also I am known.
Amen. You can pause here. We wanted just to up to verse 8, but you have extended many parts and many of and what even they never needed to hear.
Yes.
But it's a blessing. Amen. When you understand this. So you see, when things are failing, that marriage is because love has been left out.
Yeah.
Involve love. Put it there. Allow the three loves to be in that marriage. Agape, that's God. That's what is being described here.
Yeah.
Then Eros love, and also filial love, which is described in Hebrew chapter 13, verse 1.
Yeah.
This brotherly love, let it continue.
Mm-hmm.
I want to say, all this, when this happens, you automatically take care of one another. You meet yourself, you are concerned, you take care. You are concerned about the life of the other person.
Yes.
But when love fails,
yes,
and it's not there,
yeah,
you're not meet yourself in the place where you are supposed to be.
Mm.
You meet yourself at the wrong corner.
Mm.
And that is where many couples are now. Mm. The man is wicked.
Mm-hmm.
The wife is unkind. So what is happening? They are treating each other. They are competing to make like each other suffer. Like an enemy. I will make you suffer. I will make you feel that you also offended me. So this is a competition of beating each other, bringing each other down, not taking care of each other.
Mm-hmm.
And that is not what people vowed when they came into marriage.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You're bound to support one another, to be with there.
Mm.
You want somebody that can live with you the rest of your life, and somebody that you can be proud of, somebody that you can be supportive to.
Yes, yes,
and
yes.
This is where the couple is supposed to go back to. We are taking care of each other, concerned about your husband, concerned about your wife.
Mm.
I know you have so many other things that you can take care of, but what about the other person? There's some, when the children arrived, they forgot. When there are so many things that have happened in life.
Some have shifted to take care of their businesses, their careers, their children, and many other
and
things.
And they have forgotten, they need to take care of
each other. Yes.
So, point number two, maybe you can take us to the point number two, why do they... Do they fail? Why do they fail to love one another?
Yes, this is another thing that has become a cause. When you fail to cleave and you fail to compass, failure of cleaving and failure of compassing. When it comes to man, man is supposed to cleave to his wife, and when it comes to a woman, she is supposed to compass. That is to win, to who, and also, of course, to protect, to protect her husband. But if a woman abandons this, according now to Jeremiah, 31 verse 22, we are being called back. And actually the word of God is calling us, come back, you backsliding
women.
So it means if we backslide, if I backslide as a woman, I will never take my responsibility of protecting you as my husband. I will join the enemies. I will join people who are fighting you. Whatever is trying to bring you down, I'll make a league. I'll be in that team, and this is what is happening to many ladies. They are already in the team of what is fighting their own husbands. They are no longer shielding them. They are no longer wooing them. They are no longer winning them. So what you are supposed to speak to this man so that he can come on your side, so that he can be excited again, so that he can feel respect. Those things have ceased.
We were talking about yesterday calling the boy again.
Calling the boy again in a man. If I fail to call that boy again, some men have gone back now to their own mothers. Because that mama can call me that, oh, how are you, my boy? Have you eaten? I would like to see if you are being taken care of. So there are some men who have shifted, and their wives are fighting them daily. They are saying, my husband has turned to be something else. He has turned to be mommy's boy. Because mommy has got that power to call the boy in this man. And now when it comes to wooing, there are men who have fallen into traps of other women. They have fallen into the wrong hands, because the woman who is supposed to win him, the woman who is supposed to woo her, this woman has gone for a vacation. There are some women who immediately after maybe they got the firstborn, secondborn,
They forgot the mission.
They forgot the mission, and they went for the vacation. And some said, I arrived. What else do I want? I got the husband. I wanted the husband, and I have him. I tell you have him, but he may go. We have seen even men full of the anointing, men full of tongues and all those things falling. Why? There is something that they were introduced and it was cut off. And some men have become victims. They have been hunted and they have been caged because they were searching for something that they were introduced to and they are no longer getting it. And I remember of a testimony of one young man who was saying, I have a problem with my wife. My wife, whenever we are in a disagreement, she uses her own body to punish me. When it comes to the intimacy. And now when I go out there, I'm meeting some women. Some of them are not even born again. They are trying to trap me. So I am in a battle. Should I give in? Should I not give in? And who is pushing this man?
The wife.
So we have some men who have become victims out there.
Because they are not compassed.
They are not shielded. They are not protected. They are not getting that comfort. They are not getting that honor, that respect. They are not getting someone whom they can cleave to. It is the responsibility of a man to cleave to a woman. But now if a woman resists this man, I push you whenever you want to cleave to me, I am disinterested. I'm telling you, don't disturb me, don't bother me, useless, going for nothing. I don't know why I followed a useless man like you. It's like I was blind. It's like I was not seeing what type of a man you are. And some men are now, they are unable to cleave to their own wives because they have been pushed and pushed and pushed until they are grounded. So it is the responsibility. If we go back in this mission of taking care of one another, as women, we will take our responsibility very well. We will not fail.
This woman must continue winning this man.
Yes.
Wooing him.
This
being attractive to this person.
Yes.
So that whatever attracting this man to you does not
fade.
Fade. Yes. It's still there.
Still there.
That beauty. You're making up yourself. You are still looking good for this man. But now you see, sometimes now ladies, they relax.
Yeah, some of them.
They relax. Some of them relax. And say, since I got him,
I'm okay now.
I'm not looking for a man anymore.
Yeah.
So what is the hand advice to those who say, I'm not looking for a man anymore?
Actually, when you reach that...
Should you look for a man once and then after you get him, you just become anything?
There is a mission of making this man more and more. So the moment you get a man, you
continue winning him.
There's something that we say, there's no ready-made man.
Mm.
We make a man from the raw material. There's a man that you always see when you are courting each other, when you propose to one another and you are courting each other. There's a man that you see in that man.
Yeah.
And that man, you must work him out. You make him until he manifests to be that man. So a woman who is in a mission of making a man, she will never relax. She will never relax. But any woman who is content, you just get married, then you say, I got what I wanted.
And that's all.
You had no vision. She had no vision. She never saw the kind of man that she wanted. So somehow this woman will relax and she will fail in her responsibility. But a woman who knows the kind of a man she had in her mind, she will always be in a business of making this man, and she will know it is her responsibility. Every time when I woo you, when I win you, when I'm doing all these things,
I protect, I am encouraging you.
Yes.
Making you cheer up every time you face challenge.
Yes, I support what you're doing. When you come and you're down, the ones that I am releasing are the ones that are making your environment very well. When you come home, you come into the environment of peace.
Yeah.
So this is the things that I provide for you will help you to cleave.
Yeah.
You will not be detached. You will not slip away from cleaving. So many men, they are having a problem to cleave to their wives because the environment makes them to be very slippery. Whenever they try to connect, what they are getting from this woman, they cannot connect. So I advise, if you are out there and you are married, you are a full-time supplier of love, of that, I mean submission. You are a full-time supplier of respect, full-time supplier of honor. You are a full-time supplier of protecting.
Beauty, even beauty.
Yes, you make sure that you are not disorderly. You see, there's some people.
Not disorderly.
Yeah, they are very disorderly. You meet a man who does not know any other posture or any other look of his wife, because when this man wakes up in the morning,
the wife is asleep.
She is either asleep or she woke up, but the way she is, she is in a stockless, in her stockings, in her head. She is wearing a t-shirt. Of
a political party.
Of a political party.
Or a presidential candidate somewhere. Governor, senator.
Yes.
MCA.
So the message that this man is getting from the environment, what this lady is putting on, she's making some adverts of some companies. So she has become a billboard of some companies. So the husband has nothing. There's nothing to advertise when it comes to their marriage. This, you see, right now, even some people, even those people who do not know God, there's something you can meet with a couple.
Yeah.
They have gone, they have made their own t-shirt.
Yeah.
My king, my queen, if they have a child. So those names, they are branding their own family. They have their own brand.
Yeah.
So you meet a wife who is doing some antivats for some other companies, either some things.
And political parties.
Yes. Don't know, tuko pamoja, either as you do in
NASA.
So you wonder, who is this person in my territory? And you meet this lady, if she is breastfeeding, she's full of milk everywhere. She's just wet from her bust everywhere. If you see her,
she does not look attractive.
Yeah. Some of them, they are very careless. You can even giving you your own baby. Your own baby. This baby, some of them, let's say not everybody maybe will afford to have some diapers at home. Some of them will not afford. But those, if it's a napkin, the baby is not frequently changed. So even you are the owner, you are the father of that child.
But you don't want to hold the child.
You don't want to hold the child. The smell, everything, the way these people are, they are just, but something else that you are not able to describe. So when you look at her, you ask, is this my wife? Is this my wife or something else? And you hear some men telling their own wives, you should go out and learn how women behave. Learn how women conduct themselves. If you hear your husband is talking in parables, please understand you are not.
Now, this woman is bringing another order. There is a confusion now in the family, because there is something that the husband knew.
Yes.
A nice looking, stylish lady, perfumes, all these things. And then this time now, there is nothing like that. There is no attraction.
You said, my dear, there's something you said during our programs. You said, especially to you, advise the, and we do advise them, those that are courting. It is sometimes in honor to visit a lady without telling her
that
you're coming to our place where she stays. This is the time you know what type of a woman you are dating. Because the moment you are dating, you are going somewhere in an hotel, she can package herself. She will do everything that will attract you, but meet her in her own house.
Now, let me ask you a question, and please answer me.
I will answer you.
What will happen to a man marries a lady the way she looks, but later he comes and discover the poacher, the structure, was not us, it was man-made?
Let me answer that question.
What really happens to this man?
Number one, we encourage people to maintain purity and holiness, meaning that when you are in a relationship, there are these types of marriages that we talk about. Marrying in your spirit, spiritual marriage, there's married marriage, and there's the physical marriage. The elderly people, they don't wait until they are are blessed as husband and wife. They say, let me just discover so that I will not be deceived. These are the people who just go and they fornicate, but there are consequences
Of that.
Of that. What I will advise, because I have seen ladies, I have seen them. Right now, we thank God, they are releasing some products when it comes to bikers that are spongy. If it rains, my dear, it is.
Some of them you will be shocked.
You'll be shocked when they are rained on because they won't just be apes. They won't be apes. Some. I met some years back.
Who told them all men like big ears?
I don't know. That is suffering discontentment. I remember some years, I think it was back 1999. This is the time we saw a scenario of some ladies who are tying their
With towels. That time there was no style. The idea had not come to the designers. That they can put sponges on bikers.
They could put on a kinyansa, a short. Then they tie themselves with the towels, at least to increase
themselves. And give themselves a shape. That is not theirs.
Yes.
That's faking.
Yeah, it's faking.
So, it's like a fake currency note.
The way you design it.
Because that's something fake. Yeah.
So I advise you, if you are slim, be content.
Should you fake to be loved?
No.
Because at discovery stage, this is what now brings rebellion.
That one cannot even wait to discovery stage. That one immediately after marriage. Will you live in...
That's after marriage, that is discovery. Because now you have started to discover who you married. So this discovery, it can even lead to that.
So when it comes to ladies, be content. Be content
with how you look.
With how you look. If this person will love you, let this person love you the way you are. The way you are. If you are slim, be the way you are. Don't exaggerate yourself. Don't do something that will exaggerate yourself because it will be known. It will be known. Even if you catwalk...
Don't even make yourself like a Christmas tree. A man is not after Christmas tree. He's after wife. So don't make yourself like a Christmas tree. Be moderate. Be moderate in everything. Yes, we like beauty. We like decoration. But
depending.
It does not. There is something you will do until people now will eye. You will not now become what you are supposed to become. You will become something exaggerated. May God help us. So to Christians, I think that should be very far away from us. Faking how you look, faking everything, it should not supposed to be like that. Because it won't be discovered anyway. And things, it's good you say, who I am, this is how I am, do you like me? Genuine, be authentic. And this will help us.
Now,
I want to talk a bit about cleaving also.
Yes.
There's some women who are good.